Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to create this chalkboard arrow. Here you have the design that I will be using today. The way that I created this is that I went onto images, shapes I mean, and then I selected the square and the triangle. And then I just pretty much resized the square to the length that I want the arrow to be. And then I just flipped the triangle around, and then I attached it to the square, and then I resized it as well. So this, you can make it as wide or as tall as you want it. And then once you're happy with your arrow, you will select both images, and then you will go onto actions, and then you will go onto weld. So what that means is that it brings it together and it's just one item now. Then you will go ahead and place the chalkboard vinyl onto your mat. Just remember to place the chalkboard vinyl facing up, and then just let the machine cut it. Okay, now that that's done cutting, you will go ahead and weed out the excess material, and then you will remove it from your mat, and then you would take your wooden arrow. I will be linking down below all the items that I'm using today. All right, so the first thing to do is the easiest, in my opinion, is that you grab the side and you don't remove the complete back of the piece, because sometimes it can be a little tricky because the vinyl is very sticky. So you want to make sure you don't make any mistakes, because once you set it on the wood, it's going to be very difficult to lift it back up. So what I do is that I grab the sides and then I place it onto the wood. And then once I'm happy where it is, I slowly remove the back piece and then I put it down. So making sure that there's no air bubbles either in between the vinyl. And that's it. That's pretty much how you do it. Okay, and so then you would just grab some chalk and then you will write on it. So I just wanted to show you two different ways of removing the words from your chalkboard. So the first one is to use an eraser. And then the second one would be, let me write something first for you. I'm just gonna rewrite the same phrase. So the second way is to just get a paper towel and then just remove the letters out. So the problem of using the eraser is that it gets stuck to the wood, as you can see here. So just be careful with that. So that's why I will recommend using a paper towel better, especially when you're doing a wood project. So I really hope that this video was helpful and that you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing, and I will be back with more videos.